a lot of the stuff that we design, no one's ever made it before. We don't even know if it's possible to make it. I think the origins of chemical biology is how chemistry interacts with biology and gaining an understanding of that. Originally, that has often come through natural products. The classic example is aspirin. People used to chew willow bark as pain relief 3,000 years ago. And then a couple of hundred years ago, people discovered what the active ingredient is. It's like salicin. And then aspirin was designed based on the chemical structure of salicin. And then as chemistry's got more sophisticated, we can then identify the natural products, characterize their molecular structure, and then think about how you might design therapeutics based on those. You mess with a biological system with a compound, and because you know exactly what that compound's doing, you can make an inference about the way the biological system is working. We identify or develop tools that enable people to interrogate the function or the location of a protein, all the way through to really quite translational projects where people will say, there's this really cool protein, can you help us figure out if we can drug this protein, can we modulate it with a chemical tool, a chemical probe? We have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of like different chemical starting materials, and you'll start with small kind of fragment sized building blocks, and the synthetic process is stitching them together in a particular orientation or a particular way to build a drug-like compound. We can use computational methods to design small molecules, or we can do screening approaches where you take a library of small molecules and see which small molecules perturb your system in the way that you're looking for. It can take weeks to optimize one step, and if you're doing a 10-step synthesis, that's how you end up with, like, you know, months-long projects. If you're gonna engage with something like that, you have to be really, really sure that you want that compound at the end of the process. If it's like the killer molecule, then it's worth it.